Bia that was sharing her worship, Hallelujah, as we show the different Hebrew words of that are hidden under the word praise of Hallelujah, that we're going to be expressing and showing to the audience today as we get to get the revelation of understanding what we are grasping of the commands of Tehillim, the psalmist that played the worship, the psalmist that played the worship, and they were commanding audience or the people to hear the word and to worship and submit into the worship of what was going on inside the audience of the in the Bayit house of Yahuah. When David, when he orchestrated this, he prepared it entirely. So here we are now, and we're coming together. And how you doing, my brother?
Toh, brother, it's great to be here. It's taxing to change your understanding of something. Like, it's like to go from the name, the pagan name of the J-man, to go to Yahushua, or from going from saying praise the L-O-R-D to Hallelujah, which you're going to be talking about. And these, all these words have a they have a specific meaning, and so it's the concept of praising, you know, it can change with the words that we're using.
Yeah, and you know, and we have we're stuck. Just like when I shared the definitions of the word love, that's been BB shotgun blasted over five Greek different words, or and five different Hebrew words of expressions in Hebrew, or other words that we're discovering, with the same thing is happening with the word praise. Now, in the Christian community, they put, there's seven words. They say there's seven words, and those seven words are the seven different meanings of Hebrew, which I showed six of them, because I couldn't find one of them, six of the words in the pictorials while my wife was playing Hallelujah song. But there's actually nine different words, which we're going to try to go, if this goes into a two-part, that's fine, it lines up perfect, because then we're going to do the Peshach breakdown and start going through Peshach. And it was an orchestrated command. David made over 2,000 instruments and knew how to play them and taught people how to play them. He created it according to the scriptures, and I'll put down the verse on the screen when we edit this. So the actually two confirmations of verse by the mouth of two or three witnesses everywhere be established. He taught them to be, they say maestro of an orchestra of the worship team of Tehillim. Okay, right. So and they would command these certain things according to the songs, these expressions in Hebrew, which right. We're going to find out. And all the Christians know, and some of the Messianics, because the teachers are not teaching them properly, is praise and worship. Praise and worship, just two words.
Right.
They don't have no idea of the different other Hebraic expressions. Now, what I want to make clear to the audience is this. I want to greet you in the Shem of Yahushua HaMashiach. I want to greet you in that his berakot will come upon you, that the berakot would overshadow you of Yahuwah, and his ruach of his presence, of his kodesh ruach, would fall upon you and anoint you to have ears to hear and to receive. We command every mind-blinding demon and every shadow of doctrines of men of Christianity coming from the what we call the liars of Catholicism, that Christianity has inherited the lies of their forefathers as well. And we command those things to come off. And we ask, Father, that the people would open up to receive what we're about to share and comprehend and understand with an emunah of understanding of the Torah and the Tanakh and Brit Kadasha, which we're going to share in the scriptures, so they can get a true understanding of worship and praise and the different Hebrew meanings, but also that they will never, never, if there's a man that calls himself a pastor or worship leader, they would never steal worship from the Father. Amen, amen, amen. Now, because we're going to share some things with you today that in Christianity, especially more than any other group in the evangelical ministries, they are stealing worship from the Father. And there's a certain aspect of reason why. What have you noticed, brother? Like we were sharing, preparing last night. And my experience, because well, I want to share this in the beginning of this part one and part two, because you got to get the grasp of it. That my wife and I, being when we, our ministries was always a worship ministry. We enter in, and sometimes we had three services a yom, and we do it three times. It's just as long, an hour and a half, worshiping right. till we enter in and feel the presence. We got convicted as we're going more closer to Yahuah and drawing with from the messianic movement. To a little bit like almost the Hebrew words to now where we at now, more of a Yisrael grafted in, that we have went through stages of the Father quickening us things right. that we were wrong, that right. we inherited from Christianity, and right. the things that we were right and the things that were wrong to throw away.
Right, and you know, and you have this way, you have to do that in order to grow.
Right,
you can't. You know, like whatever I believe and how I worship today, in a year from now, it will probably be, and I know it will, a little different because, you know, I'm gonna learn more things and I'm gonna take other things that I used to use and throw those away and use what the Father. See, the Father is constantly revealing in His Word what He how He wants us to. Pray to present ourselves to Him, just like this, like just really quick, like I've learned that reading the Word is great, and I used to read the Word constantly, man, just constantly, but my prayer life was not as good as my reading life, and so, but I've learned that that the only way I can read until I'm blue in the face, but if I don't have that prayer time with Yahuah, then I'm not getting the revelation of what the Word is saying. The way that He communicates, the way that I grow is by learning the kind of stuff that we're going to talk about right now. You know, and so it's a constant. You know, in these days we're constantly growing, learning different things, and coming into realities, different. The Father shows us, you know, what we need to put away and what we need to keep.
Okay? Right.
So
it's like when I'm visiting Israel at different times, I'm visiting Jerusalem, and I'm hanging out with different groups of rabbinical, and some are Sephardi, and some are the what they call the Nubian, Ethiopian, Hebrew Israelites, and I noticed that we pray as Israelites, as the house of Israel, we don't pray facing people, we don't have an image, we don't worship right. with an image in front of her, no pictures, no image, blank wall. It could be a tallit up there, it could be the Torah, but we're not worshiping the Torah, we're just praying towards it in a circle around it. And then we're very careful if somebody gets up front when we're praying,
right.
not to pray with that person standing in the front.
Right.
And in the Hebrew understanding, they're very cautious of this. They teach them when they're growing up as children, the protocol of never to have any image in front of you when you're praying. There'll be right. a wall, blank wall, like I do here. I close the door and face Jerusalem with a blank wall. Mm-hmm. You know, there's none of my children's pictures, any pictures in front of me, okay? It's a blank wall, but facing to east. So when I started noticing that, and it reminded me when the Father convicted me, he quickened me, convicted me, and we set up an altar in the Messianic congregation.
Right.
And the altar has all these beautiful banners and pictures, and the pulpit's in the middle, and the worship team is part in the middle and all that. And I noticed when the anointing was coming, my wife started and I talking, because we're very communicative when during this, well, how did it go? What do you think about this? What about that? We started noticing the more we started getting closer to Yahuah and Yahushua and the understanding of the traditions of a of the roots of Israel, grafted in the house of Israel, we took the this fake altar, this building,
right,
with the three or four step degrees that, you know, we don't realize we're copying Masons. And when I looked at my Baptist book on the mission statement and protocol of how to make a building and do the altar, they do everything with the choir on one side, choir on the other side. It looks like a courthouse with the juries. Right. It looks like the judge in the middle with the robe, and then you have the steps of degree going into the jury box, as well as the choir box, as well as the altar up in the front.
And this was done where in the
the Masons tell you in the Baptist books, the Baptist books.
But now this but this is done in the Christian
community.
Even when, you know, when we were going to a non-denominational church or whatever you want to call it, then this is how we
construction
how it's constructed, right?
They don't put the Torah on a flat table in the middle and everybody get around it and do the praying and reading, and, you know, and of course you have a semi-worship altar, but it's not set up like a courthouse with the robes and all that, okay. So we got convicted, and my wife put her, she wanted to be more closer to the air conditioning, so she put her, and you can actually see it online, some of our old Yahuah Praise Worship Live, where there's no words, as you can see the old buildings. And she went more to the, if I'm facing the building, more to the right, and put her choir and her and the keyboard more to the one side of the wall, and then we put the drum and everybody else on the other side of the road, and my pulpit or my scriptural stand was below the three steps on the level of the people.
Right.
Okay.
So you weren't up on the altar anymore.
Yeah.
And see, the Yah put this, gave you this revelation.
Right.
That's what I was talking about.
He was correcting.
He's always giving us revelation. So how we worship today may not be what we're doing in a year from now, because we're growing and Yahuwah's revealing things to us constantly, all the time.
Right.
And you have to be humble and take away the things that he doesn't want and add the things that he does, or
because we got this false information that how to construct the building, how it looks, where how to set it up, it's all fake it till they make it, and they look good. Well, I like the way this setup is,
and if I may say, that's where the problem lies, you see, because those become inconvenient truths. So people are inconvenienced, they're inconvenienced by these things that Yah saying, hey, this is how you know, don't steal the worship from me. He revealed that to you.
Mm-hmm.
So what did you do? You were obedient and you did away with it. But what if you have a church like John Hagee and you're down there on the altar,
or the Charlton,
or whoever it may be, you know, I'm not just saying him, I'm saying whoever it may be, and you're sharing with thousands of people, what are you going to do? Are you going to get off the altar? Are you going to give all the worship to Yah?
Right.
Or is that too inconvenient and you're just going to go ahead and do your own thing anyways?
Right. See, what we did, and the reason we're talking before we get into this study, because that's why I believe it's going to be a two-part study of Hallelujah and the true Hebrew words, is that the second level, after a year of doing it that way, the second level was I was up, because I used to rap. I used to rap the songs and flow, and my wife would come behind me with the keyboard, my daughter thumb on the drums, on the bass, and my other daughter on the drums, and they'll flow. We'll flow for 30 minutes, and I would just, one word will come in me, and then I'll just flow in rapping with these Hebrew words and songs, and they'll come, and people would get into it. They'll get into it, okay? They'll flow, and we'll feel the anointing. But one time I'm up there in the altar, what they call the altar, the higher step, okay?
Right.
And I felt this spirit come upon me, and I felt the anointing really strong in the central area where everybody was focused. And I'm up there doing the music, singing along, and the girls are singing with me, flowing with me, because they'll chant behind me the words I will bring up. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, and then what happened was I felt this anointing, and I felt something come upon me: pride, false admiration. And I heard a still voice inside me said, "Son, don't steal my praise and worship. I'm taking my presence. Step down." So I stepped down, turned around, and faced the same direction of the people.
Right.
From that day forward, I never did it again. I would always step down and face with the people towards the place of the blank wall.
Right.
The blank wall. We had a picture up there once, and I'm not going to say what it was. We had a picture of this fake it till you make it J-man, like a Hebrew J-man, you know, mm-hmm. Messianic J-man. And the father said, "That's an image. I didn't look like that. Get that down right now."
Right.
Now they're looking at that image in the altar. It should be blank. So we took it down. And it was, mm-hmm. and then we had a stake. We had an old rugged cowboy stake up there, you know, wooden stake, yeah. which is kind of cool, but it's still an image.
Right.
So right. we got rid of the stake, and there was a blank wall. We went through stages till there was nothing there. And the Father showed me to be very careful not to steal his worship. And as long as I did that in obedience, he would allow the anointing to flow. And people were getting miracles in the audience without nobody praying for them, pouring oil, prophet lying over them or nothing. Just people right. were getting healed and having miracles. Sickness would just leave their body while they're sitting there worshiping. Nobody's falling over in the power, falling over the floor, and going right. shaking their legs and going into right. doggy barks. No, just the sweet presence of the right. Kabod, the Kabod presence of the cloud of Yahuah. And so, so the Father showed me specifically where he was taking us. And the things we're going to share with you today is we're going to show you this, what we're sharing this first 15, 20 minutes with my wife playing a little bit of the worship music is to get you in the understanding that Christianity is not only backslidden of itself and some of the messianic movement, but the worship team and the preacher is stealing the worship of the Father presence of the Ruach. The same way they call him Lucifer, but his real name is Garal. Gariel is H-A-L-A-L. And underneath the word Lucifer, and there's different ones because he's a worship leader, and because he's a worship leader, his name has praise in it, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So because of that, he could subtly, craftily, in a soothing way, with unconsciousness, get pastors and ministers and rabbis to literally sponge off the anointing, not in order to minister and get revelation, but take it for himself with admiration right. and pride. And that's one of the words we're going to look at. It's a bad praise. It's a praise that you're stealing, and it's like you're stealing the admiration, you're stealing the honor, you're becoming prideful and right. arrogant who you are, more above than you are in the esteem you should be honored in. And so we shared this with you because we want you to know that this goes on in many of the congregations, and this is separate from them like singing the song, and I'm going to use the word King of Glory, two pagan words. And the J-man in Yahushua is not even in the whole song.
Right.
And they're singing to the sovereign of the goddess Gloria over and over and over.
Right.
And they feel the presence of some presence in the room. And I remember when a messianic congregation was singing that song, and I felt like leaving. The Father said, "Don't leave. Stretch your hands. They're going to think you're worshiping," towards the worship team, and bind the charismatic spirit of the goddess Gloria. And when I did it, within 20 seconds, the worship leader opened his eyes and looked around like that fake it anointing left him.
Right.
Because it was the goddess Gloria manifesting on the platform when they were singing
right.
that she was a sovereign.
Right.
You know what I mean? And
right.
they don't even look at the words, that what they were singing there, because it's a modern, popular, charismatic, evangelical song, and they have no idea what they're singing
right.
to. You know,
right.
And then the worship team are being pumped up with that spirit, because the spirit would possess them, the charismatic spirit, and to even manifest gifts of musical and worship ability, because charismatica gives gifts. That's what
right.
she does. Okay, it's a fake gift of the Ruach Kadosh, and it's the Greek gifts. And so, do you think for 1 minute, people, that the Greeks didn't sing and worship? Were they pagan? Look online. The Greek different, they used to sing to the goddess of the glory of the Trinity of Grace. You know what I mean? They used to sing songs to her. They worship her in their audience, and people felt the, they felt the Spirit. Right. They actually felt the Spirit. So we need to understand that we used to think as Christian, the Christian community, that we had everything in a box. Oh, we got the presence, and the Baptists don't, and the other denominations don't. And we, but they don't realize they were tampering with other seducing spirits.
Right.
Because they were summoning them, because they didn't have no idea that a Holy Spirit is not the Ruach Kodosh.
Right.
It's a completely different address. Yes. Okay. So with all that said, before we go to Esau, do you have to add anything to that before we go to
Esau? No. Let's go ahead and get into the word.
Showing this to you in Esau, because I want you to follow along or learn how to use the equipment. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go to, you got, this is a trip what I'm going to tell you. In the book of Revelation, if you were to look up Hallelujah, it's only found four times in the whole scripture.
Okay.
But it's hidden 500 plus times. Okay? And it's hidden in PTL. Praise the L-O-R-D. Now we know that L-O-R-D is...
equals B-A-A-L.
Right.
Okay. Plain and simple.
10 top Christian dictionaries. Eight of them out of 10 dictionaries, eight of them will tell you that L-O-R-D is B-A-A-L.
Right.
Balaams, the five spirits of Balaams. Yeah. Okay.
Now, when we say, and I'm going to say the words so that you can understand what I'm saying. When you hear the word Baal, that's the L-O-R-D. That's the Lord.
That's
okay?
The Lord.
Okay. Yeah. And when you hear the word Balaam, it's the same one. So when Eliyahu is asking, are you going to continue to believe in the Baalim, which means the L-O-R-Ds, all kinds. There's many of them, all different ones.
One's a female.
Right. Right. So that's what he's saying. So a lot of people are calling today on the L-O-R-D in the Christian community. Praise the L-O-R-D. Well, which one? You need to make up your mind which one is, who is Eloah? Who is the mighty one of Israel? Is it L-O-R-D or is it Yahuah?
That's right.
You know.
That's why Eliyahu said in that battle, he said, today, how long are you going to be between your two opinions?
Right.
You're either going to serve the mighty one of Israel, or you're going to continue serving the L-O-R-D.
Right.
Baal, B-A-L, which is five of them. One is a female goddess married to Yahwehism, the Yahwehism.
Right.
Okay.
Which is a Canaanite deity.
It's a Canaanite deity. So now, what I did here, I went to Esau, I pulled this the little binoculars, and you see... praise the L-O-R-D in different fashions and ways over 502 times, but some of it is praise the name of Yahuah, praise the praise him, the G-O-D, praise the Elohim. There's different expressions. Now, and I'm showing you this with highlighted in yellow, you can see it. Praise is 1984 and it's Ha'al, which we're going to see that type of Hebrew worship. And it's part of the name that they disguise with Lucifer, the Latin word. It's Catholic Latin word, Lucifer. It's not his real name. And then the other one is the Father's name, which is 3051 in short, Yah. Okay, so now, this will take a lot of work. I just want to let you know, it's hidden. Hallelujah is hidden 502 times in the scriptures, in the Tanakh, in itself. PTL, praise the L-O-R-D, is only found once in Romans, which we're going to go to it, in the whole Brit Kadasha. Now, if I were to take out the, because you got to realize the is a filler word. Like if I look at right here, as you see in Genesis 29:35, okay? In Genesis 29:35, there is a, it says praise, and then, there's no the. The does not exist. That's a filler word. Now, for there is a the in Hebrew, and it's ha, H-A. And once in a while, you'll see a number with that word. Now, let's look at Judges right here, 5:2. You know, it's kind of blurry on your screen, but in Judges 5:2, it says, "Praise ye the Lord." Now, ye the is English filler words. All right. It is praise Yah. Praise Yah.
So praise Yahuah. So that would directly translate to the word Hallelujah.
Yeah. That's two right. Hebrew words
right.
stuck together. Okay, so now I just want you to see it. Now, if I go up higher in Judges 5:3, you notice that they have italics, light letter here, where it says, "I will sing praise to the Lord God of Israel." Well, the word praise is not there. To the is not there. So it says, "I will sing Yahuah Elohim of Yisrael." Okay, so what I did was I take out now the. I'm going to take out the filler word, even though some of the words have Hebrew, but I'm going to take out the filler word. Now we have 253 times PTL. Okay, because I took out the other words like praise to his name, praise him in his place, praise that, praise God. Well, it's really praise Elohim. Right. So, and now I'm squeezing it down to 253 times. If I want to get critical, it is actually 71 times when I looked at the Hebrew, the true praise Yah be praised. Okay, right. Hallelujah. Only it's 222 times in the Tanakh, the Torah and the Tanakh. Okay. So I broke it down to 222 times, but in actuality, it is a total with different forms of worship, especially in Tehillim, 500 and plus times, like I shared with you earlier, 502 times, and then we're looking at 253 times of different forms of PTL as well. Okay, now I wanted to read that, let you know this. Now you say, well, how is it Hallelujah? Okay, we're going to show you how is it Hallelujah. Okay, I'm going to go to 1984. And it's going to appear in the bottom. See in the bottom of the screen, 1984. The only difference from Lucifer's name, because he was the worship leader, he was a praise leader. That's why right. praise is a part of his name. It's a part of his character. Okay, so praise is here saying like 92 times praise. Praise 19 times. Of course, esteem and honor, splendor, 12 times, mad, that's like a mad praise, you're going crazy, a boastful praising, boasteth, praise, or boasted himself, foolish, fools, it's got a lot of different words. Okay, now, 1984 is our focus. Now, in the Brit Kadasha, the Christian community called the Nuevo Testamento, the New Testament, okay, it's only four times. The word Hallelujah. So we're going to go to the word Hallelujah, and we're going to look at the Greek and look at the Hebrew origin, and we're going to confirm that this PTL, okay, right. is the Hebrew words for praise Yah or Yah be praised. I throw be praise Yah, praise Yah. Either way it works, but it's really right to left. Okay, so now we're going to go to Revelations. So this word, which is it is pretty big word in the Christian community, don't you think?
Yes.
They say Hallelujah a lot. Even right. the Catholics say Hallelujah. They don't have an right. A because it's Aramaic. It's actually, Hallelujah is actually Aramaic Hebrew, the modern Hebrew. Okay? So we're going to look at Revelations chapter 19. They happen to be only in chapter 19, the four times. It does something now. That kind of baffles me. It's only mentioned four times in chapter 19. It makes you wonder what's going on here. And PTL is only found in Romans, which we're going to go to that next. Okay, so here you see here, and after these things, this is Revelations chapter 19, verse 1. And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in Shamaim saying, Hallelujah, salvation, okay? And esteem and honor, esteem, splendor, and honor, and power unto Yahuah, our Aloha. Now, I'm going to punch in here. As you can see, I'm going to go to it and punch in. I'm going to click it. And I'm going to move this up where you can see it at the bottom. And it's 2390. If you notice here, it says Hallelujah. He Greek or Latin. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Of Hebrew origin, imperative 1984 and 3050. And it says, right. Praise ye Jah. But we know it's praise Yah. There's no ye there. That's a filler English, right. King James word, or praise the. Those are filler words.
So maybe you can show them the word ale.
We're gonna break it down,
and then so that they can see that duh or ye,
right? It doesn't exist. It doesn't exist, yeah. Right? So as you see, it's 1984 in Hebrew is ha la, and Lucifer's name underneath his real name has H A L A L, which is a different phonetic breakdown because they put the apostrophe to divide the closed consonant, open consonants, either two or three, and it would be Chael. That would be his real name, one of the names, you know, of the dragon. So
well, he was in the presence of Yahuwah before,
yeah.
So he has a Kadosh name.
Yeah,
the name is Kadosh.
Yeah, name is Kadosh.
Yeah, yeah.
And the Catholics changed it to Lucifer,
right.
To hide it, you know, right. So we can't get a depth of the real understanding of all that secret sauce they do. And then 3050 in Hebrew is the short version Yah for Yahuwah or Hallelujah. Yah,
right.
The Yah 3050 in your Strong's Hebrew Greek accordance. So it's 1984 and 3050. Praise Yah. They say Jah here because this is a modern E-sword. They put the J instead of a Y because the J's are only about 400 to 500 years old.
So even in the Greek,
it shows it,
right? Because it says Alleluia, and the Greek is 239, which is actually reference to the Hebrew 1984 and 3050.
Now, if we look up here in my little box on the top, you'll see Judges 5:2, praise. This is a different praise. This is Barak. Okay? If I go over here to Deuteronomy 26:19, it would be Teliah. This is what we're going to discover, okay? That they hid the different orchestrated worship leader commands with the word praise. They hid actually seven commands, but there are actually nine different Hebrew words for praise. Okay, I'm not playing with the Greek today. I'm just showing you the Hebrew. Okay, so here it says in Deuteronomy, praise and in name and in honor. So he's got Shem here, and you notice that and in does not exist in Judges 5:2. Praise ye the Lord, which is supposed to be Yahuwah. It would be Barak Yahuwah. And if we go over here in Judges 5:3, that's italics like letter, didn't even exist. Okay. And we go to 1 Chronicles 16:4, it says, praise the Lord. All right. Elohim of Israel. Well, first of all, praise is 1984, which is all. And then, like we get Halle. And then you got Yahuwah. There is no the, it's not there. No matter where I go 250 something times, you will not find a Hebrew number with the word the. Is there a the in Hebrew? Yeah, it's ha, H-A. And if ever you find a the with a number, then you will say ha. Hey, ha, hoo. It's an expression that you could fill it in or you don't need to. It's a filler word, even in Hebrew. Ha. Okay. Ruach ha kodesh. The ruach. Kodesh Ruach. You don't need the to express Kodesh Ruach.
Right.
Kodesh Ruach. Kodesh Ruach. You don't need the Kodesh Ruach. You know what I mean? Or the Yahuwah. You're making him not intimate when you say the. Okay? Okay, you're belittling him. So you can say ha if you want, but which is a place in Hebrew that you use it once in a while. But as you can see here, the audience, that there's actually no Hebrew number in all these places I'm showing you. 2 Chronicles 25:3, praise the Lord, praise Yahuah, praise Yah. Okay, so
that's why the commandment says do not change the esteem of my name. I mean, that's one of the Ten Commandments.
That's right.
It says do not change the esteem of my name.
So if you put this word Hale,
yeah,
and you put Yah, you got Hallelujah, plain and simple. Right. Okay, it's the same in Greek, it's the same in Latin, it's the same in Latin letters in English. We say Hallelujah. So many people say, yeah, we Hallelujah is the universal Hebrew word in all Christianity and every language of the world. Well, because it's Hebrew, they're speaking the Aramaic modern Hebrew. If they put an H, I mean, excuse me, but a Hallelujah, and it's almost like Ale, Ale, Ale. In the worship song my wife does, she's Hale, Hale, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Yah be praised. So she's trying to get you to understand the Hebraic understanding in that song we played earlier. Okay, 253 times it's hidden in the term PTL. Now, what about the TV program PTL? Who are they praising? Hello? They're praising BAL, the Balaams. They're PTLing the balls.
What they say, brother, is that we're still praising the same deity. Don't you know?
Well, say the same thing about us. Muslims say that they pray the same deity.
That's what we say it in our language, brother. That's the way. But you know what?
You're going to be the Christian advocate today. Yeah.
But you know what the word of Yahuwah says? It's in Psalms. If you read in Psalm 56:5. It says, all day long they twist my words. All their thoughts are evil against me. All their thoughts are against me for evil.
Come on now.
So then, if you're saying those words and you're replacing the name of Yahuwah with the LORDs and the BAALs, then you're doing exactly what
it's
called,
G-O-D.
But you know what? That's our language, man. That's how we say it. That's what people tell me. It's okay, Al.
It's an evolution of words.
Yeah, it's okay. You're being too critical. You know, it's inconvenient for me to have to change my language. Why doesn't he come into my understanding? I don't have to go to his understanding. He needs to come to mine. You see, that's the mindset.
It's selfish.
Yeah, it really is.
You know, Yahuwah, you know my heart, Yahuwah, and you know my language, so you're going to have to adapt to me.
Yeah, you're gonna adapt
look in
your
my heart.
To
yeah,
me.
He's going to look in your heart and see laziness not to know the Kodesh language of Yahuwah.
Well, what he says is that if you read Jeremiah 17:9, you will know what Yah says about the heart of man.
That's right.
That it is continually
deceitfully
deceitful,
wicked.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it is above all things deceitful. I think that's what it says. And continually wicked. Something to that effect. I can't remember exactly how it says it. But anyways.
All right. So now look at 2 Chronicles 29:30 on your screen. And we see... it says here, sing praise unto Lord, which is Yahuwah, with the words of David. Now, I'm going to click this, and then I'm going to jack it up here, and I'm going to let you see it, and we're going to go to ISR, okay? And it says, the sovereign Hezekiahu and the rulers order the Levites to sing praise to Yahuwah with the words of David and Asaph, the seer. And they sang praises with gladness and they bowed their heads. If I look at it in the Orthodox Jewish, it's beautiful the way it is spoken here. Okay. I'm just showing the people the little scattering of the 253 times, okay? That it's only Hallelujah, praise Yah, Yah, praise, Yah, Yah, praise. Either one is parallel truth, it works, okay? And you want to put praise be to Yah or Yah be praised, fine. But the hallelujah is strictly two words
right. Put
together, okay? So, and they hid it. Why in the world would the Catholic scholars and then the Reformationist translators using the Catholic codexes and all these Tyndale and Wycliffe, why did they just go ahead and put hallelujah through all the places? They kept it. They hid it. They hid the Hebrew understanding of it. Because see, once you start digging in underneath each word praise, which we're going to go to, you're going to find that there are commands for the people of how to praise him in that moment with those songs.
Right.
Okay? So, that don't need coaching. Just the word. Barak! Yeah. Barak him! Get on your knees and face and bow your head.
Right.
You know what I mean? Tell him, raise your hand and jump and scream. You don't have to say, okay, everybody get off your seats and do this.
No, so they already knew what to do.
They knew what to do because it's in their nature. They're Israelites. Right. They're not a bunch of coached Christian community. Not to be coached. You know what I mean? Because they have a lack of knowledge. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Right.
And they're praising other things, the people. There's people, my heart goes out for the house of Israel and the house of Yehuda that are in the dens of whore houses called Christian Circes. They're in whore houses worshiping false deities, female deities, and don't even realize it, you know? And the Jews are just as guilty. A lot of the UD in Hollywood, they're so into the psychics and so into the new age and so into the tingle, crickle, clingle little feeling of goosebumps. And so they have to get, you know, we have to break it down. We're going to go back here to Revelations. And I'm just going to tell you it real quick. Revelations. We looked at chapter 19, verse 1. Right?
Yes.
And after this, I heard a loud voice in a crowd in the Shamaim saying, hallelujah, deliverance and esteem and respect and power to you, our Elohim. Now, think of this word hallelujah here in this verse. He was hearing this from Shamaim.
Wow.
Did they say PTL in the Shamaim? Not according to this verse. He said he heard a loud voice of a crowd in Shamaim saying, PTL? No, who are they praising? Yah be praised. Yah praise. Deliverance, esteem, respect, and power to Elohim. Let's go to verse 3. The second time they said, who said? The voices in Shamaim. Hallelujah. And what happened? Her smoke rises up forever and ever. The third time, verse 4, and the 24 elders and the four living creatures fell down and worshiped Aloha, who sat on the throne, saying, what? PTL? No. Omin hallelujah. Omin hallelujah. Now, if he was hearing them say it in Shamaim, hallelujah, who are you to change it to PTL 502 times?
Right.
Woe is that scribe and that man of that pen that did that. You know what I mean?
To hide the esteem of Yahuwah.
Right.
To
his name, Yah.
To steal the praise. To steal the anointing.
And then look at verse 6. And I heard a voice of a great crowd as the sound of many waters, as the sound of the mighty thunder saying, come on, people. You know, we read it all the time and we don't realize it wasn't Yahu Kanan saying hallelujah. He was hearing them say that in his Hebrew understanding. He was hearing them say it in verse 6. And it was like a voice of many waters. And none in those waters, there was not a group of them saying PTL.
Well, the waters is people. So then, so there was a mass of Kodeshim, I'm sure, that were saying hallelujah.
And then it goes, for Yahuwah El Shaddai reigns.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful, beautiful. You can't, I mean, it's just like, it's so awesome to see this. If I were to go even to the...
But you wouldn't know that it says that in the King James Version, because in the King James Version, it says, I want to read how it says. It says, saying, Alleluia, Alleluia for the L-O-R-D-G-O-D omnipotent.
Oh. Oh.
Reigneth. He reigneth.
Yeah, he reigns. They're throwing Alleluia there, and then they put the B-A-L in there.
Right.
And then the G-O-D on the dollar bill.
Right. The which came from the G-U-T, from the Norse deity.
Right.
The gut, which was written on the belt buckles, by the way.
All the Nazis, Germany.
Nazis belt buckles of Germany that said, in G-O-D we trust.
We're killing all the Jews, all the Arabs, everybody, all the Polish. We're going to burn them the fire because we trust in G-O-D.
Yeah, that's right.
Now look how it says it in Orthodox Jewish manuscript. And I heard as it were a sound of a great multitude, a sound like Ma'im Rabin, many waters, and a sound like mighty thunder saying, Barak Yahuah, they say Hashem, because Yahuah Eloheinu reigns El Shaddai.
That, you know, but I just want to say this, it's still, even though it's in Hebrew, I still don't agree with Hashem.
No,
I still don't agree with that. It, you know, it's sad that our people are saying
the name, That's their L-O-R-D there. Right. You know, and so everybody's guilty of. It's not just the Christian community. Our rabbinical brother, Big Brother Judah, is doing the same thing, the very same thing. So now. Now that you see this, now let's go to the one time in the Brit Kadasha that the word PTL is only found, Romans chapter 15, verse 11. And there's a reason why it's found there, right? And you're going to see this. This is fun stuff, what we're doing. Chapter 15, Romium, verse 11. And again, praise the L-O-R-D, all you Gentiles, and loud him, all you people. Now let's look at giving a loud means it's actually an applaud, loud praise with an applaud, shout, scream, applaud. Okay, now we're going to read it with the ISR. And again, praise Yahuah, all you goy. It's supposed to be goy. Okay, praise Yahuah. You notice they put the out, because why? It's not in the Greek, it's not in the Hebrew, the word the in this particular location. Praise him, all you people. Praise him, all you people. Okay? Now, they're leaving out some things here because of this, but I'm going to show you in the OJ scriptures. And again, hallelujah, they say Adonai, Adonu, Ko'el, Goyim, Shabbaka'u, Ko'ha, Minim, Baruch Yahuah, and they put Baruch, they say praise the L-O-R-D for the people that don't know what they're saying in Hebrew, all you goyim, and let all the people praise him, Tehillim 17:1. Now he's giving you a reference. That's why I like OJ, the Old Orthodox Jewish scriptures, because they love to put references. What the writer of Romans chapter 15:11 was doing, he was quoting a Hebrew verse in Tehillim 17:1. If you're quoting, hear me now, if you're quoting a scripture, all right, it should be purely quote. That's the problem going on with the politics right now. A guy says he's quoting something and they misquote him. So if it's a quote, it should be a quote. If I'm in the Brit Kadasha and I'm in Romans and Corinthians and I'm quoting something, you should take the exact quote of Tehillim 17:7 and quote it and put quote there.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
And don't put the L-O-R-D-E and all the other filler words and just leave it like it's supposed to be. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go to the quote of Tehillim chapter 1:17, this is Orthodox Jewish, and he says, praise Yahuah, they say the name, all you goyim, not gentilis. Hear me now, not gentilis. That gentilis is a Greek word for a female part of her body. It's supposed to be goy, and in Greek, it's ethnos, a different ethnic group other than the tribes of Israel, okay? You could be goyim, a sojourner. Praise him, all you people, okay? So he's saying here, oh, praise Yahuah, all you sojourners or other ethnic groups other than the tribe of Israel. He's telling us to praise him. So how do you praise him if you don't know his name?
Right.
They say, oh, praise the L-O-R-D, all you nations. Now look at this. They did something right here. Okay. If I'm going to quote in Romans 15:1, if I'm going to 15:11, this verse, it should not be gentilis, it should be nations. Because here in Psalms 117, they say nations, which in Greek is ethnos, ethnic group, another ethnic group. Okay? So, and the word praise is shabak. And we're going to get to this.
The plan to steal away the esteem and the praise of Yahuwah is there in every language. We're not just saying this about the English language. When you read the Spanish version, it literally says, this is how it reads. It says, alaba a Yehovah.
Oh.
I mean, it literally says it.
It says, the mighty one of destruction.
Right. It says, alaba, which means to praise, a Jehovah. Jehovah.
Right.
I mean, so which we know is another name for Lucifer.
Right.
We know that name is synonymous.
Jabuan.
Right.
And all the soccer balls of the championship of the soccer team, Jabuan, right, is they have Jehovah there.
So that's why I forget which verse it is. It says that the whole world has gone astray. Mm-hmm. Everybody, all together, you know, because unless you're keeping the commandments and you're doing. You're trying to live with a clean lip and praise Yahuwah with his, you know, the esteem of his name. Because if you're going to be saying the L-O-R-D, you might as well just say
Balim.
You might as well say Jehovah and all these other words. Forgive me, Father, for saying that.
You might as well say Dagon. You might as well say Starbucks.
Astarte. You know? And might as well say use the Astarte, the Esther, which all the Goyim right now, those who are out of covenant. That's what Goyim means. People who are out of covenant. If you're out, so if you're in covenant with Yahuwah, and people are telling you that you're Goyim because you're not, you can't prove that you're Jewish or whatever. That's not true. If you've made a covenant with Yah, and you're in covenant with Yahuwah,
sojourning,
and there's signs of the covenant, are the names. Signs of the covenant is keeping the Shabbat. These are all signs of the covenant. Okay, then you're not a goyim anymore. You've been grafted into the house of Israel, and you have made a covenant with the Father that you are going to keep the feast. So if you're walking out the feast, you're calling on the name, and you're keeping the Shabbat, then you're not a goyim anymore.
That's right.
Okay, you're now grafted into the house of Israel.
You're coming in and coming out of that garbage and coming into the truth.
Right.
And look at how it says in Psalms 117:1, oh praise 1984, and this type of praise is ha'al, and it means a clear sound. Shine, make a show, boast, foolishly rave of celebration to Yahuwah. And then is all you nations, and then this praise is 76:23 with his Shabbak. Right? It's a loud tone. Do it with loudness of words and esteem and honor and praise and triumph. So you see the word praise here twice in this verse, but each one is a different word. And it's a different expression. He's telling us how to praise Yahuwah, and he's telling us even the nations to praise him this way.
Right.
You know, it's not, oh, praise the Lord. No, it's praise Yahuah. Yeah,
with the mighty shout. That's how the walls of Jericho came down.
That's right. All right. So Romans 15:11 is a quotation from Psalms 117:1. And of course, you could see the mixture of what they did. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go to Israel, chapter 3, verse 10.
On that last verse that you were on, just to quote this real quick.
All right.
Okay, I just want to get this out there for all those who speak Spanish. Is in the SRV Plus, which is the I don't even want to say it. The scriptures in Spanish is bad the way it says it, but anyway, it says y otra vez alaba al Señor. Okay, well then, el señor, I mean, who, el señor Gomez, el señor Fernandez, el señor Juan.
The senior, senior.
I mean, is this a way to esteem Yahuah?
Him Mr. Senior?
Yeah, call him Mr. Whatever, you know? I mean, it's total disregard for who he is, you know? There's no esteem in that. There's no reverence. And even in the Hebrew, just to say this real quick, in the Hebrew version, it says, and again, Alelu es Adonai. Kol goyim shabek ohol kol ha'amim, but still his name is they pancake, like brother would say, Adoni over the name of Yahuah.
Right.
You know.
They're hiding his name again.
Right. They hide the name, you know, and it's really grieving. I just had to say that.
In every language and tongue. Now, right. Chinese and Korean are a little different. They'll say, instead of, they don't say Yehovah, they don't say Jehovah, they don't say Yahweh. They'll say Yahuah. And then they would say for Yeshua's name, Yesha or Yeshu. Okay, they have, depending if it's Chinese or Korean. They weren't Jesuit infiltrated, only in the main cities. The Jesuits got to them. So their translation is more better and cleaner. The Swahili manuscript, there was a Swahili Bible. There's a great brother that we're friends with. He put a copy of the Swahili scriptures from 1800, and Rebbe's went to Africa and made the first Swahili scripture, and they put Yahuah.
They
translated his name in 1860, 1880, Yahuah. And then here comes 1930, 1940, and they're putting Jehovah. Originally in 1800, it was Yahuah. And these were Hebrew scholars before Ben Yehuda and Jew in Israel with their dramatic dots and lines.
See,
and
that's very revealing.
Yeah.
If you look at the timeline, it's very revealing to who was in charge at that time, because you can see the difference in the names. And like Brother saying, they were being infiltrated by a different belief.
Right. So Israel, chapter 3, verse 10.
And when the builders laid the foundation of the Hekal of Yahuwah, they appointed the priest in their robes with trumpets, and the Levites, the sons of Asaph, with cymbals, to praise Yahuwah after the order of David, sovereign of Israel.
Okay, this is Asaph. Okay, and now, read it in, I'm going to read it in King Irish.
Uh-oh, we got a problem.
Irish, the Scotchman, the Bloody Mary Scotchman, Irish. And he says, and when the builders laid the foundation of the house of Yahuwah, they set the Kohan in the apparel with trumpets, and the Levites, the sons of Asaph, which are Zadok, with cymbals to praise Yahuwah. Now this word praise again is 1984.
But in the King James, it doesn't say Yahuwah, brother. It says the L-O-R-D.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to say B-A-L, guy.
I know, but that's our language. So we need that's the, what they keep telling me, you know.
You mean those people won't understand.
Yeah, they won't understand you unless you say the L-O-R-D. Yeah, because they'll tell you, speak English. We're in America.
Yeah.
Don't say Yahuwah, because that's
Let's see in the OJ, yeah. OJ scriptures. I call it the OJ scriptures, the Orthodox Jewish. And he says, and when the Bonim builders laid the foundation of the Hekal, Yahuah, they set the Kohanim in the their robes with trumpets, and the Levim and Benai Asef with cymbals to praise Yahuah according to the Melech David.
To the instructions of
the instructions David. Of David Melech Yisrael. Okay.
But there again it says Hashem.
Yeah, they're covering his name a little bit. People are getting the OJ scriptures. They like it. I told them it's good to learn Hebrew, but realized I tell them it's just like a King James, man.
Right.
They even put ye and thou in there. Like, what is a Hebrew scripture having ye and thou in there? It's like, come on, man, give me a break. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And this is 1984 again, and Hebrew origin with 3068. And what we're going to do now is we're going to actually stop there. You know, what we'll probably do in the future, when we start getting into the calendar and doing some other things, we're probably going to stop the machine, like a 1 minute intermission, 2 minute intermission, and we'll continue midrash. We'll continue the study and talk for another hour for the audience.
Right. We'd like to get to the point where we can take phone calls.
Yeah, we want to take phone calls, maybe the second half or something, prayer requests. And then also during the week, we got to start reading. We want to read the book of Enoch with clean words, the book of Jubilee with clean words, and we want to read Tanakh with clean words as well. We want to do all that together. So we might be, as soon as we get some after the feast, we might start kicking in overdrive, okay? And we're going to kick it in some overdrive. So during the week, people could throw in their prayer requests. People could have midrash and throw out some questions.
We're going to really try to get this website going.
Right.
Where we can share with a lot of people, and hopefully we'll be reaching more people, especially when we get into the understanding of the calendar. For right now, we know that the way that we keep the calendar is not according to the book of Hanukkah. Okay, but we believe that Yah is going to be teaching us, and we're going to do all we can to share that with everybody out there.
Right, to the best of our knowledge.
Right,
because see, all of us have a piece of some truth.
Right,
and the stuff that's going on with us here, and my brother, and the Yahu, that the piece of the truth with the Hanukkah and Jubilee. It's really amazing. I don't even want to get into it because we'll go with 30 minutes just having fun talking, because we found in the Brit Kadasha scriptures, I mean the Tanakh, there's words they have added like sunset and sunrise, which are the years 1300 and 1400, making a ball globe earth
to fit into the concept of a globe,
right?
Instead of
eastward and westward, which means it's going to
what it says is the sun going eastward or coming from the east and going towards the west,
right?
That's
and they threw the light is sunset illuminated. And sunrise, you know, which is fake it till they make it words, and people read that and they take it for doctrine truth instead of reading it in Hebrew. That's what I was so appreciated with a Rebbe one time said. He was surprised that I was reading the book of Yasher. He said, how could you read Yasher? The book of the light is written only in Hebrew. And I said, forgive me for giving you this bad news, Rebbe. You know, because he was a ascetic Rabboni. I don't call him Rabbi. I don't like to call him. I think I call him teacher. I said, there's a man, a rabbi in Florida in 1800. He translated the book of Yesher into English, and he was upset. He said, the honor of understanding that book is to know Hebrew, because in English you'll never be able to understand it. And he was right.
Yeah.
Because Enoch's the same way, Jubilee's the same way. No matter how much we try to translate them into the Nazarene English, the words.
We can get to where we understand it, but we have to do a lot of studying. We got to get the scriptures into Hebrew, break down the words because you don't know the translator that translated it, and that's the problem. That's why you have so many, I believe that's why you have so many people with so many different revelations. But Yah's putting it out there to where people are picking up on it, and they're making calendars, and they're getting closer, they're trying, and they're getting closer to the right moed, which is the right time of the festival. So Yah is revealing in these days, giving people revelation about the feast and the calendar and all this. But with there being, there's so, I've already seen like three different translations of all these books. You got the one, you got the translation of Yahweh's word, you got the translation of
Nazarene,
and
the
then
the Catholic Christian one,
right,
with LORDs and GODs.
So there's several different translations, and a lot of the little words are changed, so you don't get a full revelation, or not everybody gets the same revelation.
Now, if there's anybody
because
out
of the different
there
words
that know a link, and I think I'm pretty sure I probably got a link, but I'm just putting it out there for fun. If anybody got the Book of Enoch or Jubilee in Hebrew.
In the Hebrew, yes.
From the Qumran caves.
Right.
All right. They have it in Hebrew. Please let me know so we can research it.
Right. We want to get a copy so that we can break down each word, especially the words
of the calendars.
Of the calendar. We really want to know what it says in the Hebrew.
The different gates and the portholes and things like that.
Yes.
Okay, so we love you. We Shabbat and Shalom with you. And may Yahuah give you Shalim Shalom. You know what Shalim is? That's the prosperity.
The prosperity.
Forever prosperity. When you're in Israel, you see the cleaner's truck says Shalom, Shalim. Shalim cleaners, you know, the prosperity, the best one, the best of the best. You know what I mean? And so we want you to have a great Yom. And we thank you for tuning in to EaglesHavenMinistry.com, Ha Eliyahu channel, and Eagles Haven, or should I say, EliyahuChannel.com. And also, if you're listening by a CD or watching by a pre-recorded DVD, we thank you. Tune in to these websites. See our pre-recorded or pre-stored files on YouTube as well as in EagleshavenMinistry.com. And check. What were you going
to
say?
I want to say Tehillim 150 in Hebrew before we leave everybody.
All right.
Okay. It says, Hallelujah, Allelu Kebekocho, Allelu Berkia uzo, alelu vigorotav, alelu kerov gulo, alelu beteka shofar, alelu benevede hinor, alelu vetofu machol, alelu benemeve ugav, alelu betsitzele shama, alelu betsitzele teruam, kol hashamatea leya, alleluya.
Hallelujah. Yah be praised.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you for tuning in. And I'm going to leave a picture of Hallelujah in Paleo Hebrew.